One thing you have to notice here, there is no way to represent the 0 in the floating point representation. If we try to represent 0 by making all the bits in the floating point representation as 0, then also we cannot represent the 0. See here, we made all the bits in the floating point representation of the fractional number as 0 and thinking that it will represent the 0. But see what's happening. Minus 1 to the power 0 sign bit, then 1 point the zeros, then into 0 point exponent minus bias. If you do like this, we will get 0.125, not 0. So this is the special case. We cannot represent 0 by making all the bits in the floating point representation of the fractional number as 0. To store the 0 in the floating point fractional number, we have a different concept called the denormalized form. If all bits of the exponent parts are zeros, then this is called the denormalized form. The way we treat the denormalized form floating point numbers is slightly different from how we treat the normalized form floating point numbers. For the denormalized form, we have the different way to treat the floating point number. This is minus 1 to the power s into 0 point significant into 2 to the power 1 minus bias. Notice that earlier we were using 1 point significant. In the denormalized form, we are using 0 point significant. Earlier we were using exponent minus bias. Here we will use 1 minus bias. So this is the difference how we treat the floating point number in denormalized form than how we treat the floating point number in the normalized form. Now we have this one. Let's treat it as denormalized form. So let's find the decimal number for this floating point representation. But at this time, let's treat it as denormalized number. Write minus 1 to the power sign bit into 0 point significant, 0 point these 4 zeros. Into 2 to the power 1 minus bias, not exponent minus bias, it's 1 minus bias. Minus 1 to the power 0 is 1, this is 0.0 and then 2 to the power minus 2. And finally it results 0. So if we treat this number as denormalized form, then this number will result in 0, not in 0.125. Now let's convert this floating point representation of fractional number into the decimal number. Since all exponent bits are zeros, so treat it as denormalized number and write minus 1 to the power sign bit 0 into 0 point this significant 0.0001 into 2 to the power 1 minus bias 2 to the power 1 minus 3 and this results 0.015625. So we have seen these 5 types of floating point numbers. First one is normalized form of floating point number. In this case, exponent is not all 1s or all zeros. If we have normalized form of floating point number, then we convert it in decimal as minus 1 to the power s into 1 point significant into 2 to the power exponent minus bias. Other one is denormalized floating point number. In this case, exponent is all zeros. And we convert the denormalized form of floating point representation as minus 1 to the power s into 0 point significant into 2 to the power 1 minus bias, not exponent minus bias. So see the difference between two. Then after we have minus infinity, we already seen. Then we have plus infinity. Then we have NaN, not a number. So these 5 types of floating point numbers exist in the computer. This is the maximum number can be represented as 8-bit floating point representation of the fractional number. Because all bits in the exponent cannot be 1. So this is the maximum number. 15.5 is the maximum number can be represented by 8-bit floating point representation of the fractional number. And this one is minimum. It's actually the maximum in quantity, but we made the sign bit as 1. We made the sign bit as negative. The internumber distance between two floating point fractional numbers is very less in the floating point numbers compared to the fixed point fractional numbers. Floating point numbers has a high precision than the fixed point numbers. In the computer, we use the floating point representation to represent a fractional number. There are two types of floating point numbers in the computer. First one is float. This is 32-bit, also called single precision floating point number. And other one is double, which is 64-bit, also called double precision floating point number.